is similar to sin. I can tell you a few things that come to my mind, and I just want to remind you, because that's how sin is. If we know the sin in our life, we will know how to mitigate it, how to attack it. Number one, sin begins with small and it grows. It begins small in your life. You can look at the things that we've fallen into in the past. They all begin small. A little lie, a little cheat, $1, one unclean look, one try of this, one try of that, and it pulls your legs, and eventually your life, this is exactly how leprosy is, starts as a small patch. Small patch, you don't even see it, and it slowly starts to spread throughout. Number two, leprosy is painless, and so is sin. You can't feel it. It starts to grow inside of my heart without me noticing that it is sin, and the same thing is with leprosy. Number three, it is infectious. Not the leprosy I showed you in the picture. The real leprosy is an infectious disease. And so is sin. Remember the parable of the apples. If you get 9 good apples and 1 bad apple, you put them in one basket, what do you think is going to happen? The 10 apples will be rotten from one bad. Same thing with sin. And that's why it's important for us and for young men and women, and even for us, and even for older men, to choose our friends wisely. Wisely. Godly friends, because they will rub on you any way or the other. Eventually, leprosy eats the nerves, and patients tell us that they don't have feelings. And so does sin. It makes you numb. And if you live in sin, and after sin, and after sin, and are surrounded by sin, and in a family with sin, and in a community of sin, you become numb. It doesn't matter anymore. You don't notice that you're doing something wrong. Although people would have 2 other things that liken leprosy to sin. Usually, people who have leprosy don't notice their disease. They feel good. Are you suffering? No. Are you in pain? No. Can you work? Yes. Can you do everything? Yes. And so is sin. Sinful people like me usually don't notice that we are at fault. And that's why it's important for us to go to meet our Father of Confession to tell us this is wrong and this is right. You're walking the right path or you're walking in the wrong path. Last but not least, leprosy has no cure. If you are cured from it, it must be the act of God. And the same thing with sin. Only through God one can conquer and defeat sin. And those are the likens of leprosy and the sin together.